Hey, Duke. I was wondering if there was a way to determine what gear ratio you have in your differential without opening up the diff cover.
Hey, DJ. Thanks for the great question. Now, there are ways to determine your gear ratio without having to open up your differential. Now, the differential, also called a pumpkin, yes, I really did that, is a mess if you open it up. The gear oil is stinky. It takes a lot of time. It's just, you want to avoid it if at all possible. But there are some places that you can check and things that you can do to determine your gear ratio without having to go there.
The first place to check is really easy. It's in your glove box, most likely, or your paperwork when you bought your vehicle. It's the window sticker, also called a Monroney. If you have a build sheet, if you had it custom built from the manufacturer, you'll also find it there. As you can see right here, stock, this 2005 F-150 was a 355 ratio limited slip. So 355. Now I've changed it to 456s, but that's how it started its life.
Now if that doesn't pan out, there's two other places that you can check, on the axle and the differential cover itself. On the axle, you might have a sticker, and on the differential cover, you might have a little metal tag that's sticking out. That will have the gear ratio stamped right on that.
Now, if you're still not getting anywhere, jack up the rear end of your vehicle and mark your wheel and the drive shaft. I just use some blue tape. And then turn your wheel one time. While you're turning it one time, count the number of rotations on your drive shaft. That will determine your gear ratio. Now, in my case, it rotated about 4.5 times, and my gear ratio is 4.56, so I know this test works spot on.
Okay, so you're still not getting anywhere. Well, guess what? You're going to have to crack that differential on open because you're going to need to get to the ring gear and possibly take a look at the pinion as well. Now, if you can get to the ring gear, turn your wheel until you can see the stamping on the side of it. You'll see the number of teeth. That's the number of teeth for the ring gear and the pinion gear. You can't find it? Start counting. Count all the teeth on the pinion gear and the ring gear. Then, once you have those two numbers, divide the number of teeth that are on the ring gear by the number of teeth that are on the pinion gear, and bam, you have your gear ratio. Okay, here are my last few bits of advice. First, if it's a new vehicle, don't go ask your salesman. He's not going to know these technical details, and if he does give you an answer, it's probably going to be the wrong one, so just don't even bother. The other one is to check online forums and Google the answer. You might find somebody else that just bought that vehicle and they have the exact same question and they have the answer. But your vehicle might still be different. So the best thing to do is to use all those techniques and look at all those places that I just showed you and you'll have your answer. Thanks, DJ. Thanks for asking Duke.